है, हमें पता है पिछले 1 साल से, लगभग मार्च एंड से, मार्च 2020 से हम लोग कोविड का सिचुएशन देख रहे हैं, और सेकेंड वेव काफी डिफिकल्ट है, ये आप सब जानते हैं। सो ग्लोबली जस्ट कुछ स्टेटिस्टिक्स की अगर बात करें, क्यों इंडिया में लोग ज्यादा परेशान हैं और हम रिलेटिवली बेटर न्यूज सुन रहे हैं यूएस से, यूरोप से, सब जगह से। तो अगर ग्लोबल आबादी 7.9 बिलियन है, 790 करोड़ है, तो 16% आबादी इंडिया में है, 1.3 बिलियन पीपल। और अगर ग्लोबली जितने कोविड केसेस हैं आज तक, मतलब अगर जब से शुरुआत हुई तब से लेके आज तक अगर देखें, तो 16% केसेस हमारे इंडिया में दिख चुके हैं। अभी तक तो ये सब कुछ ठीक है, लेकिन अब क्या हो रहा है, हर दिन जो नए केसेस आ रहे हैं, आप सुनते होंगे, आप टीवी में देखते होंगे, ऑफिशियली रिपोर्ट होता है कि अप्रैल एंड में लगभग 400,000 न्यू केसेस डेली आ रहे थे। अब वो चीजें थोड़ी पिछले 2-3 हफ्ते में, मई से, जब से गवर्नमेंट लोकली स्टेट्स ने, सबसे पहले महाराष्ट्र ने शुरू किया रिस्ट्रिक्शन, फिर कई और स्टेट्स ने, गुजरात ने शुरू किया, सब जगह शुरुआत हुई, और अब हम देखें तो ऑलमोस्ट इंटायर स्टेट, हर स्टेट कोई ना कोई फॉर्म में रिस्ट्रिक्शन लगा रखा है, चाहे वो बहुत स्ट्रिक्ट हो या कम हो, नाइट कर्फ्यू हो, दिन में आप जा सकते हैं, ऑल्टरनेट डे जा सकते हैं, कुछ डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स में जा सकते हैं। तो ऑल ओवर इंडिया, मतलब लास्ट टाइम हमने देखा कि सेंटर ने, मतलब नेशनल गवर्नमेंट ने हमारा आकर के पूरा पैन इंडिया लॉकडाउन लगाया था। इस बार वो सिचुएशन नहीं है, लेकिन इस बार जो भी लोकल स्टेट को लग रहा है कि भाई ये चीज बंद करनी है, बिकॉज उन लोगों ने पिछले 1 साल में कोविड को कैसे डील करना है वो सीख लिया है, वो ये नहीं कर रहे कि सब कुछ बंद कर दो। सो इट हैज बीन अ मिक्स ऑफ मिक आई मीन इट हैज नॉट बीन दैट स्ट्रिक्ट अ लॉकडाउन। अगर हम बोले 100, लास्ट टाइम इफ इन अप्रैल एंड मई द लॉकडाउन वाज अराउंड 100%, टुडे इट इज 70% इफ वी हैव टू सी दिस। सो देयर इज अ बेटर लर्निंग। ऑल्सो बिजनेसेस ऑल्सो हैव अ बेटर अडेप्टेबिलिटी टू कोविड। सो आई मीन लास्ट टाइम अगर इफ यू वुड हैव हर्ड द न्यूज, रफली एवरीबडी, ऑल द लेबर्स दे वर माइग्रेटिंग अवे, एंड बिजनेसेस जब हम रिजल्ट सुनते थे, सो अराउंड 70% ऑफ देम दे वर सेइंग दैट देर वॉज आई मीन देयर लेबर्स हैव गॉन अवे। बट इफ यू हियर द कमेंट्री राइट नाउ, सो ऐसा दिखता है कि 30%, 20-30% लेबर्स हैव गॉन, बट मोर और लेस लेबर सप्लाई इज स्टिल देयर। सो दैट इज अ लर्निंग व्हिच वी हैव गॉट। बट व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम टुडे, इवन एज you have cases moderating in India, if you will see my right side graph, around 40% of the new fresh cases are still coming out of India. And the second problem is that the number of death which is getting reported officially, which is also very high, roughly around 4,000 fresh death, which we are seeing daily, and we all know, आप सबने local media में पढ़ा होगा कि ये under reporting है, we don't buy, I mean the extent of that which is reported. So just to give you statistics, prior to COVID, 26,000 deaths daily होते थे, अब अगर हम 4,000 death और COVID के cases में देखें, तो officially जो report हो रहा है, 1 in 7 death is because of COVID. So that is why everybody is worried. We have seen moderation in FII inflow, but Sandeep said in his earlier comments as well, that COVID and market has not been so related. Even last time around, when we were still dealing with COVID, market was doing better. And even, I mean, it has been seen in many other countries also. Markets have not been impacted so much by the COVID during the second wave. Whichever country, whether it be UK or certain other European countries, they have not seen market getting disturbed so much by COVID. Now I'll move on to say, so like I told you that it has spread pan India. Previously, what was happening is that most of the cases were getting reported out of Maharashtra. Now it is the South Indian states which have taken the lead. ऑल्सो एडिशनली देर इज अ लार्जर पेनिट्रेशन ऑफ कोविड इन द रूरल एरियाज ऑल्सो. So these are some of the problem areas which we should keep in mind. But the positive point is that now cases appear to be peaking. And just a couple of days ago, I read a report by ThyroCare where it seems to say it is said that even as only a handful of population have officially confirmed that they have COVID, antibodies are now being found in more than, I mean, roughly around 60% of the population. So that is why, even if you think that vaccination will pick up pace only in July, right now we have around 1.8 million doses getting administered every day, but government tie-ups कर रहे हैं और there is मतलब हम expect कर रहे हैं कि जुलाई से जो ये supply है वो काफी meaningfully ऊपर होना चाहिए. इससे हमारा expectation है कि roughly second half में हम देखेंगे और भी ज्यादा लोगों को vaccination पड़ रहा है, जिस वजह से एक natural जो डर है. आप बोलेंगे ये, आई मीन आई नो देर इज अ थिंग दैट पीपल आर गेटिंग कोविड डिस्पाइट गेटिंग वैक्सीनेशन, बट इट्स स्टिल इट इज अ लोअर प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन विच इज गेटिंग कोविड, एंड वैक्सीनेशन इज फूड प्रूविंग टू बी द एंड गेम टू स्टॉप कोविड एंड रिड्यूस द चेन और ब्रेक द चेन. सो दैट इज वाई वी एक्सपेक्ट दैट मोस्टली समवेयर बाय द एंड ऑफ जून एज अ बेस केस देर विल बी वी विल Right now, we are talking about moderation in economic activity. By the end of June, we will start to talk about pickup in economic activity. And that is something our base case. But COVID has always surprised us. We never, no, none of us in February, we thought that we will be talking about second wave. So we should keep that risk factor in mind. But these are some of the positive developments. India has vaccinated around 11% of its population with at least first dose. There are some countries which are doing much better, such as US, UK, Singapore. And that is by a lot of time in news you will hear globally growth data is much better than what it is coming out of India. With regard, what does all these mean for economic activity? Because हम mainly हमारा purpose है कि अगर हम COVID के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं तो हम ये जाने how does it impact our economic activity? So we were expecting around 12 to 13% growth in overall GDP 2 to 3 2 months ago. We have pared it down because sequentially, if you will see broadly between March and May, activities across the board has on an aggregate moderated by 20%, which has led us to pare down our growth expectation. And now we expect growth for India to be around 10%. So हम ये कह रहे हैं कि last year के comparison में we will have, I mean, economic activity grow by 10%. Some things which are still very good and working in favor is global demand is very good. So we will continue to see improving exports, cargo activity, so forth. Then your commodity is moving up. So that sort of benefits all the commodity producers, जैसे farmers हैं, उनके income या agri traders हैं, या हम metal producers हैं, इन these are the guys who benefit. The unlike second wave, in the first wave, we have much, I mean, first in the first wave, government was just starting or RBI was just starting to reduce the rate. Now we have an extremely supportive monetary policy, not only domestically but also globally, which is helping to provide liquidity to the system. Yet there are some risks which we should keep in mind, and that is why we've pared down our growth, is that unorganized business or lower income of the strata, lower income guys, they are affected. So there will be an impact on demand from those segments. There will be business challenges in those segments, and there are employment losses in those segments. So these are some of the positives and negatives to keep in mind. What does it mean? It means that for the market or sector as a whole, anything which is linked to global growth, will start to do much better. Then you have government supporting various schemes such as production linked incentive schemes. There are infrastructure push. So even as COVID must have led to some slowdown in infrastructure projects, but overall we are fairly confident that CAPEX plans that government has, infrastructure plans that government has, that will go through much better. Consumption we find is the weakest link, consumption demand, but because India has a very vast population of 1.2 billion, where consumption accounts for roughly 55 to 60% of GDP, not entire consumption cannot be painted in the same brush. There will be some segments which will be harder hit. There will be some segments which will do relatively better, which have a better income protection. So these are broadly on growth. With regards to earnings, the broad snapshot has been that the earnings had been moderating. The sales growth had been moderating even prior to COVID. Even in September 2019, December and March, we'd seen a degrowth in sales. And COVID accentuated that sales decline. However, activities were just starting and sales were just starting to pick up. And we saw a 16% sales growth for Nifty companies in the quarter ending March. The base is so low for June and September that despite some sequential moderation, we will see an improvement in the sales growth in YoY terms, even in the coming quarters. But what is more important, that larger businesses, despite the weak sales growth, they had adapted themselves. They had cut down on a lot of expenses, administrative expenses, travel expenses, and in general, advertising expenses. So despite the fact that in the March quarter, there was a rise in the raw material cost, you saw gross margin decline, but EBITDA growth, it still improved, and the PAT growth also improved. Right now, looking ahead, overall for the Nifty, even as you incorporate a lower sales growth, we do expect a plus 20% growth in the Nifty earnings. And I guess Gaurav will come later on to the fact that earnings have been so depressed for last several years that the it is now like looking ahead to move up, especially because of the fact that banking sector more or less have cleaned up. There has been corporate tax cut just right before COVID in December 2019. So all this still paints, despite a moderation in economic activity, all this still paints a positive picture for the earnings recovery as a whole. Yes, like I told you, there has been rise in input costs. In fact, this is a Bloomberg released aggregate commodity index, which has jumped 51% over last 1 year. And whether it be metals, whether it be food prices, food or energy, or precious metal, practically all of them have risen over last 1 year. And in fact, in some of the items such as copper, aluminium, it is expected that it will be a long run to rise. For many other, such as food items, it is expected that it is only because of COVID disruption. It may moderate in the near term. So this has led to some dent in the margins and earnings of the companies or the sectors which consume commodities such as auto, staples, discretionary, because even if they have taken the price hike in January and some 2 to 5% price hike in April, they have not taken it commensurate to the rise in the input cost. So there is some dent in the margin, but still, as of now, the margin is the margins, profit margins are above the trend line, and the prospects are still more on the positive side than on the negative side. Now, these were all about COVID growth and earnings. I'm shifting the gear and I'm coming to prices and inflation, because a lot of you might be fixed income investors who want to know how much should we be worried about rising global food prices, rising commodity prices, and hence the inflationary concerns in India. So what happened over last 2 years, and especially what has been happening इज दैट इंडिया हैज एडमिनिस्टर्ड प्राइसेस. आप सुनते होंगे गवर्नमेंट एमएसपी निकालती है. इट इज देयर फॉर सीरियल्स, इट इज देयर फॉर पल्सेस, इट इज देयर फॉर शुगर, इट इज देयर फॉर कॉटन. बिकॉज ऑफ विच वॉट हैपन्ड दैट इवन एज ग्लोबल प्राइसेस वर वेरी वेरी लो, दे वर कमिंग डाउन ओवर लास्ट सेवरल ईयर्स, योर इंडियन प्राइसेस वर रिलेटिवली हायर. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं आपको बताऊँ, शुगर प्राइसेस हमारे कई साल से 32 rupees per kg है. Globally, they were, I think, below 25. It is just now that sugar prices have caught up to what the domestic levels are. And in fact, last year, जब सब जगह global food prices कम हो रहे थे, I mean, I'm talking about the same time last year, India was having a larger challenges on the retail front, and because of that, your India food inflation was high. We are saying this time around, even as there will be sequentially your food prices will rise because of a very high base, you will see inflation coming down in India, but it will go up in many other economies. So on an average, we expect inflation to moderate and stay in manageable levels. Yes, there will be rise in fuel inflation. There will be some rise in goods and services also. But as an aggregate, we think that overall inflation will be under the manageable levels. And RBI will not focus so much on inflation as it will be focusing on growth. We know RBI has been very supportive, and RBI has taken interest rate to record low, liquidity is abundant, and there is a targeted approach to provide liquidity to the sectors which are in need, and that is likely to continue throughout FY22. That is again and again the commentary that we are getting from RBI. With regards to government tax collection, yes, there is a risk that government tax collection could moderate, but government was already very, the bottom line that I want to leave you with is that government was already very conservative in its estimate. When the budget came out, we thought that we were already saying that taxes would surprise on the upside. Now we are saying that these targets will be met. And just today, the news have come by that RBI, which it was initially thinking it will be transferring 50,000 crore to the government, it is now transferring more than, I think the figure is around 91,000 crore to the government. So overall, we think government fiscal revenue should stay manageable, and government should be able to go with its spending plan. Yes, it will have to once again reorient more towards the stress sectors, maybe toward rural. No news on that front, but we do expect that may come by. With regards final comment on the currency, dollar was appreciating between Jan to March. It has again started to depreciate. So when dollar was appreciating, particularly in March, April, we saw some depreciation pressure on rupee. Right now, once again, it is sub 74. The bottom line is that the forces are such that the currency will be volatile. Overall, we expect rupee to have neutral to marginal depreciation bias. We don't expect it to depreciate very strongly because RBI has accumulated some $110 billion of reserves, and it has been accumulating a massive reserves since 2014, which allows it to, any time there is a shortfall of dollar supply in India, it can pump the dollar supply, and it has the ammunition, or uske paas utne shastr hain ki wo rupee ko bahut appreciate होने से रोक सकते हैं.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme related documents carefully.